And we have the latest coming in when it comes to the Hindenburg report. The Congress is now once again training guns at the center. Leaders of the Congress are now going on to claim that no institutions are sacrosanct in Amritkal. My colleague Hina is joining us as she gets us the latest. Hina, the Congress since yesterday has been training guns at the government over the fresh revelations made in the Hindenburg report, which has been vehemently denied by the SEBI chief and also the Adani group and also the other investors who have been named in the report. What's the latest, Hina?
Well, the latest, Sagarika, is that there is a fresh statement that we've got from the Congress party, this time from Jairam Ramesh, General Secretary Communications. And here also the demand for JPC continues. Let me just briefly take you through the, important points that are mentioned in this statement. First, he says that on February 14, 2023, I had written to the SEBI chairperson urging SEBI to play its role as the steward of India's financial markets on behalf of crores of Indians who have faith in the fairness of India's financial markets. I never received a reply. He also says SEBI, long considered a trustworthy global financial market regulator, is now under scrutiny. But let's now focus on the demand that is being made as far as the Congress party is concerned. We've been hearing about a demand for a JPC, and now in this also, Jairam Ramesh in this statement has said that no institution clearly is sacrosanct in Amritkal. He's raised a few questions also. Did the SEBI chairperson recuse herself from the Adani investigations? Do these conflicts of interest explain the prolonged investigation, a delay that has benefited both Adani and the Prime Minister while damaging SEBI's reputation? How can a match proceed if the umpire herself is compromised? So clearly not satisfied with the statement that SEBI has released already. Two statements have come in. And apart from this, Jairam Ramesh in the statement has said that the path forward is to immediately convene a joint parliamentary committee, a JPC, to investigate the full extent of Modani mega scam. So that's the term that the Congress party has now coined. They're calling it a Modani mega scam involving the self-anointed non-biological prime minister and a perfectly biological businessman. So that's the fresh attack, Sagarika, coming from the Congress party, yes, this time again from Jairam Ramesh.
And as the war of words continues, Hina, the Bharatiya Janata Party has accused the Congress of trying to break investor confidence in Indian markets. Let's first listen into what other leaders of the opposition are saying before we get you more that's coming in from the markets and responses from the BJP.
माधवी बुच ने क्यों नहीं बताया कि हुजूर मैं जांच नहीं कर सकती क्योंकि हमारा मामला, हमारा पैसा तो और हमारे पति का पैसा तो खुद ही इन फंड्स के ऊपर लगा हुआ है जिसको विनोद अडानी मैनेज करता है, जेपीसी से इसकी जांच कराओ। और तब मेरी एक नहीं सुनी गई, बल्कि उल्टा मोदी जी ने उठा के हमको जेल में भेज दिया।
The Hindenburg report, which was published yesterday, categorically shows how this entire modus operandi has been working, how institutions have been diluted, how one particular industrialist who has his interest, which was under the lens of investigation and serious charges, continues to be saved and safeguarded. We have written letters, multiple letters as members of parliament to the SEBI chairperson, which went unanswered or even unacknowledged. Just goes to show the level of the method that has been used by the entire Modi government to safeguard the interests of one industrialist and how institutions are being diluted just to protect the interests of that particular industry.
Iski uch stariye jaanch ho. Main samajhta hu nothing short of JPC. Doodh ka doodh, pani ka pani ho. Kyunki system ki aisi rigging, ye abhutpurv hai.
Let's now tell you about how the markets are reacting. So now we are getting to know the market. Sensex and Nifty have rejected the entire controversy around this Hindenburg report. Sensex has surged by 300 points. That's the latest that we are getting. And markets, like we are telling you, have defied this report that has now come in. The Bharatiya Janata Party has also responded to the claims made by the Congress party over this report. Hina, take us through what the markets are looking like, because as of now, there are many commentators who are observing the markets and they are saying that this report has been completely rejected by the markets.
Well, that's how it looks like right now, because when this report came out yesterday, there were claims, there were counterclaims. We all, expected that there is going to be a significant impact, deep cuts in the stock markets. This morning during the pre-open also, we did see some red, but now we are seeing some bit of recovery as far as Sensex and Nifty is concerned. When Sensex opened in the morning, it saw a cut of about 400 odd points, but now it has recovered sharply. A few minutes ago, it was up about 300 odd points, and now it is around 80 odd thousand. As far as Nifty is concerned, even Nifty, Sagrika, has recovered from the low point of the day. It's up about 92 points. But the impact that is being faced right now, as far as the Lal Streak is concerned, is on Adani stocks. And here I have Adani Enterprises stock opened for our viewers. It's currently down about 1.68%. But if you see, earlier there was a steep fall. It went down sharply. But now there has been a bit of a recovery there as well. So slight recovery being seen in Adani stocks as well. On the other hand, Sensex and Nifty have come back in green.
All right. So there are many, Hina, who are actually now saying that our markets are resilient and any attempt to break investor confidence will be called out and will be rejected. The controversy around the latest Hindenburg saga continues, with the Adani Group rejecting the claims, the SEBI chief rejecting the claims, the SEBI coming out with a detailed statement. We're keeping a close watch on the story, taking a short break. We'll be back with more news and updates.